So you would like to learn how to easily and effortlessly write and build out your standard operating procedures so you can enjoy your pool time while your team is taking care of business? Awesome. I'll show you how. Let me just change really fast. So now that I'm camera ready, let's talk about how easy it can be to create SOPs. Hi everybody, I'm Yvonne Hammond with AskEvie.com and I'm a business efficiency consultant for digital entrepreneurs. And business efficiency is not always just fancy, glamorous, and shiny. There is a lot of manual work that goes into your business being efficient. And a big piece of that is standard operating procedures. We all know it, and none of us really wants to write them, isn't it? It's never the tool. It's never a question of, are we going to put the SOPs in ClickUp or just a Word document or Notion, or where are we putting our standard operating procedures? That's usually not the question. When my clients come to me and I ask them about their processes and workflows, the problem usually is that they're like, yeah, I know I should be doing SOPs, get my standard operating procedures ready, get that all connected to my tasks in ClickUp, but I don't have the time. I just don't have the time to write all of this stuff out. So today I wanted to give you three tricks and show you just how easy it can be to get standard operating procedures set up, written out, ready for the company, ready for you to crush your business, ready for you to outsource whatever you want to do. And you're gonna feel like the freaking badass CEO of your company you are. So let's get you started with some really easy and simple SOPs. But before that, I wanna hear from you. Pop in the comment section and tell me, do you have SOPs right now? And while you're down there, go hit that subscribe button right here. Hit the subscribe button and the bell so YouTube knows, hey, that crazy German is doing some cool content. We're gonna show this to more people. Cool? Because we want everybody to be efficient, don't we? Now, trick number one, really simple and really great if you are a solopreneur. But even if you are already running a team and you are already outsourcing, this can save you a ton of time, especially when you're like me, who just sucks at typing. I had typing classes on my to-do list forever and I just don't get to it. Luckily, we have technology. So tip number one, dictate your SOPs. I'll show you how. Really simple. As you can see right here on my screen, I am in a Google document. Did you know that right here under tools is a voice typing feature? And the nice thing is, even with an accent like mine, Google Documents is pretty accurate with typing when I'm talking to it. Just clean it up right away when you are in there so you are not losing track of what you actually said, because sometimes some words really go a little bit crazy with my accent. But you see how easy it can be to just dictate your SOP. That's it. That's simple. Add a couple of screenshots to it or maybe a short little Loom video and you are done. That's simple. Tip number one, use Google Documents with the voice dictation feature. Now, tip number two is just as simple and amazing if you are working with the team and have a VA on board. Use Loom. The easiest way, and I literally just did that with my social media manager that is just getting onboarded, and there's so many things, and yes, I didn't have an SOP for that. I grabbed my Loom, I recorded the screen really fast of, here's what I want you to do, here is how we handle this, here's the ins and outs of Instagram, here's what you need to look after there, here's what you do there, and I literally just walk them through what I'm doing, what to look out for, and hand those Loom videos off to her to write up the SOP. It's part of her job description. I give you the information, I give you all the knowledge, you are taking those videos and you are writing up that SOP. I don't even have to do it. I taught you, now write the SOP so that the rest of the team, and when you are getting team members underneath you that you have to manage, that the SOPs are ready right away. Simple and easy. You don't have to write the SOPs. Just jump on a Loom and record it. So tip number two, Loom record your SOPs and let your VA handle managing and writing the standard operating procedure. How easy is that? Now, before I dive into my third easy hack, on how to write standard operating procedures and not really having to write them, let me know in the comment section, what are your tips and hacks to make writing standard operating procedures really easy? Let me know and hit the subscribe button. Now, tip number three builds up on our Loom recording. Not all of us have a team, not all of us have a VA where you can just be like, here go, do that, go write the SOP. You can record the Loom video, walk through all the steps, make sure you point out all those little things, like my Instagram bio actually can pull in links from a description on Instagram. That's not a common thing. So my team needs to know that that's possible and that they have to put a URL in the description. But I digress. You need to remember to really talk through the whole process. What happens where, which tool are we going in? Do the whole video recording and then send it through Descript. Descript transcribes your video. And as you can see, you easily can fix things in here, mark things, copy and paste things while still having the video on the other side. Now, why this makes life really easy is you can record one full video, go through the whole process of everything, clean up the transcription of everything, or have a VA, just a one-off VA, clean up and proofread all of this. And then once you have this whole process laid out and the transcription is cleaned up, you can go in here, visually tell which of those bits and pieces you need, mark that, and clip it to a new composition. Now, what happens with that? It literally builds a secondary file just for that piece. So now you have not just only that big all-encompassing standard operating procedure, you also can easily pull out specific pieces of your SOP to pay real attention to it. Meaning those things with Instagram, once you have this whole SOP set up and your standard operating procedure is ready, you might want the SOP to really pay attention to that one piece. You know, that piece that says we can add URLs in the Instagram description because the tool I have in my bio pulls this out and easily links that image. That piece, pull that out as a separate warning, here's something special. And it's easily done right here in Descript. You do not have to deal with any big editing software or anything. You have the transcription ready. You can fix the transcription. You easily can cut your video. And there you go. Tip number three, video record your standard operating procedure, transcribe it in Descript, and edit however you want it. Now, if these three tips don't show you how easy generating standard operating procedures really can be, then I don't know. You have no excuse left. So tell me, which SOP are you going to be building first? I want to know, and I'll see you in the next video.